Hi everyone, welcome to OneX Lab. So in this video, I'm going to explain you about extracts. So we already saw like what is extracts and what is the difference between live and extracts. So in this video, let's see how to create an extract. So extracts are nothing but snapshot of your data. Mainly for the performance reasons, we are switching from the live to the extract connections. So when you go with the extract connections, your performance will be faster. Since we are using the in-memory analytic techniques, your data is going to reside in your local memory. And also like it is going to use the Tableau functionality called Tableau Fast Data Engine Connector, which both these things help to improve your performances. So now if you see, I have connected to the sample superstore data. It is in the live connection. Now from the live, I'm switching to extract. So the extract has been getting created. That is your exact snapshot of the data. So even I have three sheets here, I have pulled only orders. So in that case, only the data for orders will be created in the extract. Okay. So once you switched from live to extract, the extract will be created only when you click on the sheet one. Only when you click on the sheet one, you could see the extract file is being created. This is nothing but a Tableau readable file with the extension .hyper. Hyper is the fastest creating extract technology which is used by Tableau. Before Hyper technology, we had used only TDEs, Tableau Data Extract. Now they have Hyper. So the extension is .hyper. Hyper produce faster extracts. Okay. So by default, it will get stored in your My Tableau repository. That is, once you install Tableau in your machine, if you go to My Documents folder in your machine, you could see a folder called My Tableau repository. This is nothing but it will act as your local repository in your machine in order to store all your Tableau files. So you can see all the data sources, extensions, shape files, map sources, log files, bookmarks, connectors, all the files will get by default stored only in this location. Okay. Even when you create the extract, it will get saved only in this particular location. In case if you want to change the location, you can change the location. But by default, it will get stored in this location. Okay. Now, once I save this extract, the extract is being created. Now we are no more connected in the live connection. We are connected to the extract which we have created now. So you can see here the data extract has been created on this particular date and time. So after this time, any new data that is being included in your original data source will not get captured in this extract until you do a refresh. Okay, this is how you have to create extracts. There is one more advantage when you create an extract. That is, you can see something called filters here. So you can also restrict your data in extracts. That is, when you are connecting with a live connection, you need to take all the records. There is no other way. But when you are creating the extracts, you can take only the data which is actually required for your reporting needs. Okay. Suppose I have 10 years of data in my database, but I just need some last 3 years of data for my original reporting needs, then I don't need to connect with my 10 years of data. I can just create a filter here. This needs to be done before creating the extract. Okay. So you can just create a filter on that particular column. For example, the date column, I choose the year. So here I have 4 years of data, right? So if I just want to connect with 2012 data alone, so if I just create this, so that 2012 data alone will be captured in the extract. Okay. So I take only the data which I actually require. So by doing this, the number of records will get reduced and your performance will get improved. So this is also one more advantageous factor while creating extracts. Okay. I hope you understood how to create extracts. Let's meet in the next video. Thank you.